Hi, creators. Welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica, and I am here to guide you through the intricacies of Maya's XGen fur. In this video tutorial, we are going to cover interactive groom splines so that we can create realistic looking fur for our character, Cora. In previous tutorials, we have modeled her, we've UV mapped her, we've textured her, and now that she's back into Maya, we're going to be using Autodesk XGen to create beautiful fur to make Cora really stand out. If you are new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, Substance Painter, and so much more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out that creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in creating fur for Cora.
All right, here is Cora, and she actually has fur along here. Now, I made a texture in Substance Painter that has fur, and I'm going to use that as a base color, but I'm going to replace it with actual fur. So the first thing I'm going to do is duplicate this, Control D, and then I'm going to isolate select. All right, so here we have the object, and what I really need from it is just this area here. So I'm going to press the number one, and most of it's actually in along this length of mesh. So I'm going to grab these, and you can see that I don't have all of the fur, so I can either nudge the texture or add it in here. So I might do that. I'm going to grab these guys. Remove these because I don't need them. Double check to make sure you've captured everything. So I'm going to select all of them. You might want to just isolate select again just to make sure everything is there. You don't have anything accidentally selected. And we're ready to extract. So I'm going to go to Edit Mesh, Extract. Doesn't look like much happened, but if I select this, you can see that it's by itself. I'm going to center that pivot and just kind of increase it a little bit. And then I'm going to delete what's left behind, which is that one. And I still have the original here. So once again, I'm going to isolate select just so I can focus on here. All right, this is located under generate. And what I'm going to do is create an interactive groom splines. And you can go to the options and you can call it fur. You can start off with the basics, density 10, all that stuff. And then you can click on create. And what you're going to get is this really large lines. It's not going to look great, but let's go ahead and render it. And it looks great. Nah. So let me take a snapshot just so I can kind of compare it and close this. So you'll notice that we got an interactive groom spline window here. We're going to open it up. It's a little bit hard to see all of the attributes because there's a lot more tools behind this. So they provided us with this pull-down menu. So go ahead and go to the top right in workspace and choose XGen Interactive Groom. And now we're going to have access to the outliner, to the interactive groom splines, plus the editors and the tools. So we have a lot of things that we can actually play with. The first one is our actual fur. Let's go to the attribute editor. And we are definitely going to make this a lot thinner, right? Not too thin. So maybe about 0.04. Oh, definitely not enough. 0.005. We'll start with that. And you can also see that it's like a square. So that's where we're going to taper it. So I'm going to go ahead and taper it. And you can also use a taper start. So it's a little bit spikier if you wanted to. If you want more fur, you are welcome to increase the fur base. And here we're going to give ourselves more fur. Now it's very long. So we're going to take a look at the scale and I'm going to reduce it to about 0.3 and basically start with that. So now I'm going to render it just to show you what it looks like. Looks beautiful. The next part we want to do is start brushing it. So we have sculpt layers over here. To the top right, you can see that we have a sculpt layer, and I'm going to bring this down again. And we have a sculpt one. And what we can do is actually start brushing. Now you'll notice that I'm in a tab called XGen, and we have a variety of tools. And one of them is for guides, which I'm going to show you guys for XGen to create hair. What we're doing right now is interactive groom, which is fur, so we can groom. So here's a brush. And what I can do is actually comb the hair downward, right? Now to control what's going on here, you need to go to the tool settings of this brush that I just grabbed. And right now my size is at 40 and my strength is at 50. You can increase the size because I'm going to need to, just because I have so much fur. And I think 50 is good. But I also need to make sure that I turn on collide with mesh because otherwise it'll actually go through the mesh. So I'm going to go and brush it. Now it looks like it's not brushing downward.
The collision distance is too high. So I'm going to reduce the collision distance by maybe 0.1 and then go from there. So you can see that it's still a little close. So let's go to 0.05. And then that way I can now brush the fur. So now I've got this. Again, I'm going to increase my brush just a little bit and start brushing it downward. I don't have to brush it completely against it, but I'm going to go ahead and just go through and brush it. So this is going to be, it's really easy. It's really fun. So let's brush, 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 brush. Just like brushing a fuzzy dog or cat. Though cats don't really, they're not big fans of being brushed. At least mine weren't.
Let me go ahead and keep pulling it this way. And that looks okay for now. To make it feel a little bit more realistic, what I'm going to do is also add a little bit of noise and clumping. Because right now, if I render, it's going to look really beautiful. It's like slick and going to one direction, and that doesn't feel too realistic. So I'm going to stop this and take a snapshot just for comparison. The next thing I want to do is add a modifier. So over here to the top left, we have a variety of modifiers, and one of them is called noise. And I actually really like to add noise to my object. So I'm going to go back to the attribute editor, and you can see that I already have a lot of noise. I'm going to reduce the magnitude because it's a little much. Now, if you guys want to go crazy, you can, but I'm just going to go ahead and reduce it a little bit. Now, you'll notice that I'm not getting too much of a change, and part of that could be because we don't have enough CV. So fur is, in fact, controlled by curves, and sometimes we need to tell it, hey, I need more curves. So in that case, we need to go to the fur base, and you're going to see that we have a CV settings. If you're going to have really curly fur, you need to increase this. So I'm going to say 8 and rebuild, and you can see now that it's not so chunky anymore. It's a lot more smoother. And if I really wanted to go add more noise, I can. So there it is. I can add a little bit more frequency if I want to. I don't need too much. There's a bunch of other things that you can do, but in general, I just want a little bit of frequency to kind of diversify my fur. The next thing is I want to add a little bit of clumping. So I'm going to add a modifier called clump. You can see that it gives me a lot of clumps. So you can see that we can control the clump scale. You can change the clump variance if you want it to kind of stick out a little bit or not. You can change the preserve length. You can decrease the randomness of it so it doesn't look so perfect. You can increase the density. So for example, I've got a few, so I can actually type in the value and maybe I want to increase it to a few more. Let's go to 15. I'm not looking for too much clumps. I don't want bald spot. So again, with the clump effect, I can reduce the clump effect or increase the clump effect depending on what you would like. So just a little bit of clumping looks good to me. I can always add more, which I think I will. So let me go back into my density and maybe increase this to 20 so I can get a lot more clumps. And let's take a render. All right, so before it was like smooth, now it's looking a little clumpier. I might increase it even more, but let's see what it looks like when we increase the size. Now I feel like the scale is still a little high, so I'm going to reduce this to about 0.2. And I definitely need a lot more, so I'm going to increase my modifier significantly. And now you can start seeing the effect. It's starting to look better in comparison to what we started. I might still make it a little bit smaller. Let's go ahead and go back into my fur itself, the fur shape, and change it this maybe to 0.08. Again, I like it a little thinner. I want it to look more realistic. Now you'll notice that one of the things that is throwing it off is the color. You can use this hair physical shader. It has a root color. So if you want to, you can have a darker root. And then the tip color can be a little bit brighter, depending on what type of look you're trying to go for. Okay, let's render. Let's make this a little brighter. Or if you like, you can also attach a map. So it does attach a map. I'm going to click on this, click on file. Because it has UVs already, I can use the base color map of my character. So it's in Substance Painter. Here's my fur over here, and I can use that. And I always recommend to put them on both of them. Right, so I'm going to do it again. This is what it looked like before, and you can see how it's looking like now. Other things that you can do is make sure that this is in raw so that it reads it more accurately. So let me go back to my fur here and change this one to raw as well. And of course, you are welcome to use the color balance to increase the exposure if you need it to be a little brighter or a little whiter or whatever you wanted to do. So you can see now that I've increased the exposure. I'm getting a little bit of the dark edges and different color variations. So let's go ahead and take a snapshot of that. All right, let's take a look at it all the way through. I am going to grab this mesh and scale it inward a little bit so it intersects with it. And I can also go into the attributes of the object, go to Arnold, and tell it to turn off primary visibility, cast shadows. It shouldn't show up at all, nor should it self-shadow or volume. So basically it shouldn't render at all, because the only thing I really want is the fur. So I don't want that shadowy look. I actually want it to look like it's going through the object. Now for these, I'm going to isolate select the fur and the mesh. If it lets me grab it. Let me grab it from here. Isolate, select. And what we can do, since I've pushed this fur in, we can actually cut it. So over here to the top, we have a tool called cut. And once again, we want to make sure that we go to the tool settings. That size is 26. And I really want the remaining length to be basically not noticeable. So I'm going to go ahead and cut these edges here because I don't really need it. So just go through here. And then go through here like this. If you feel that you need more, you can always grab this tool, which is the length tool. And with this one, you can add a little bit of extra length in areas that you might need to cover if you choose to. Sometimes it's just a nice little addition. You can also, again, use the comb to kind of help brush some of this fur back in if you needed to. So if you're trying to cover some gaps or anything like that, this can help kind of push the fur where you need it to go. So just make some adjustments, and that's basically how you get fur using interactive groom using XGen. It's actually fairly fun and very powerful and does a lot of things really quickly, and it's just really fun. So this is what we have right now. If you feel like it needs more, feel free to add more, and you can see the effects. So before, she didn't have any fur, and now with this, it really adds that extra element into her character. And that is how you use Maya's XGen interactive groom to create fur.
Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe. That is your message to me, letting me know that you like this content and that you want to see more. Don't forget to comment. I may not always be able to answer your comments, but I do read all of your comments, and I am truly grateful for the time you spent on writing what you think. Take a look at academicphoenixplus.com when you get a chance. There you can find free resources such as ebooks, 3D models, and so much more. So take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. And my little question to you is, do you recognize this background? I change my Zoom backgrounds every single tutorial, so I'll be curious if you know what this background is, and if you do know from what animation it's from, and you leave it in the comment, I will give you a little digital medal for your correct answer. So again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time.